very happy to be
personally,
back.
Personally, I think it's the elections in Greece was very beneficial for our economy, and I'm looking forward to discuss a possible extension of your actions. I know that you have already mobilized many billions for the Greek economy, but I think it's crucial, especially at our time, that we came back to growth, but we need to focus our efforts, especially in SMEs and in sectors of our economy that need support. Liquidity, you know, it's something significant for our economy. And I'm very optimistic that with your efforts, it will more, we'll be able to recover easier and quicker.
Well, first of all, congratulations on the economic recovery. I think it's been a long journey, but it's, you know, wonderful to see growth coming back to Greece. Of course, you and I both want it to be higher, but it's back, and that's a good start, and employment is rising. It's also very, very important, and we've had good discussions with Euclid and also with Yannis Kravitsakis as well about how we can help really encourage growth to be faster. I think it's EBRD has made some effort, as you know, in the last 2.5 years since we spoke when we arrived, and it's been a very fast start for us. Already, Greece is the fifth largest market for EBRD after 2.5 years. So it's 1.6 billion already invested, 31 projects, all private sector. It's been a really, really good start by the team here. And we have to thank you and your government and also the private sector in Greece for facilitating. I think the next phase for us is very exciting. We, of course, have received the letter for, requesting mandate extension. I'm very positive. I'm going to make a very strong recommendation to the board to agree this.
Till
2025, and that would, you know, give us 7 years. And operationally, with the private sector, our staffing, it becomes much easier, actually, because everyone has a longer horizon. But I think particularly over the next few years, we need to widen out what EBRD does in Greece. You know, we want to do more in the property tourism area, for example, or renewables, where we are the world's leading multilateral, but we haven't done very much here in Greece. That's the next stage. And also SMEs, as you mentioned. I was in Thessaloniki yesterday, and I took a snap decision, sitting on the sofa in the hotel, that we should open an SME office in Thessaloniki. So I have to get some money now from my shareholders to do this. Yeah. But I think it's very important because in any economy, I mean, particularly to get unemployment reduced, to get young people employed, SMEs have to grow, and we can put in some facilities for that, I think. So I go back with that idea now to the board to persuade them, but I think I want to do that. And then also agribusiness. You know, we want to help the Greek agribusiness sector get off the ground, really. And the other idea that we mentioned when we met 2 years ago, we've done a little bit of help for the municipalities in terms of just trying to measure what they have in terms of street lighting, for example. The next stage, I think, is to do what we do in other countries, which is to invest in municipalities. Athens, of course, but also the smaller ones, really in the countryside. And, you know, water, wastewater.
Maybe the small need more.
Exactly. Water, wastewater, public transport, street lighting. These are investments we've done elsewhere. We should bring that idea here too, I think, in Greece. So I'm expecting this year, again, Greece to be amongst the leading markets for us, probably somewhere between 400 and 600 million euros this year, I think, will come to Greece, I hope, fingers crossed. But we also have headroom to do more in future years. We don't have a constraint, so the more demand, the better. And I also promised my team that I would try and have more people in the office here. We know when I came here last time and I saw you, we only had three.
How many?
We had three last time. Now we have 12.